Hello everyone, this is Greyshot 117 here, bringing you another Company vs. Replay. Brought to you by... No Sacrifice, No Victory, aka T-Kev. Yes, it's been a while since he sent me a replay. It's been nice that he sent me one. Can't wait to see what he does. For anyway, he's a really, really good player from... I think it's Indonesia. I'm sorry if I get that wrong. But nonetheless, still a really good player. And his rank kind of helps prove that. Enemy team, let's see what he's versing. And he's wow, it's actually pretty even. I would say the enemy team has more rank, but again, rank means nothing, but it does help. It's like numbers. Numbers helps, but doesn't win the battle. In any case, let's see. We have Eldom, Jujeet, No Sacrifice, Metaman. We have a clan, Vlint, Gorin, a Q Laser, and Psychotron. Interesting names. Can we, I don't know, maybe have some pronounceable names? But anyway, two Vermok, two OKW, with two Americans, one Soviet, and one British. Well, these guys coordinate already, pushing already. Going for that major point right here. You're wondering why? Get this point, as you can see here, you can cut off the quote-unquote Germans, or pretty much you can cut off whoever has this territory. Same thing with this point here, you can pretty much cut them off. So if you hold this point as the Germans, even if they have this territory, it will be cut off, which is nice. So continuing on, we can see here it looks like we have a lot of forces pushing toward mid. Metaman's trying to get in this building, trying to hold. No Sacrifice, where are you? Okay, you're trying to put up your Vickers in here. Again, we have him being British. Most likely he wants to get his Vickers in here. Pretty much mow down any MG or incursion coming in. Nice play with the Pioneers. Just attack from the flank. Again, the machine gun is very powerful, especially the Vickers. But the only thing is, A, it takes a while to station. And B, you have to be... you can only aim in one general direction. Don't know why. I guess he retreated because the infantry section would have owned him, but whatever. Better shot instead. Now the Grenadiers, which can only really shoot through, by the way, one building. Maybe two. No, actually, no, I take it back. It's shooting through three. Kind of. Yeah, not doing half bad. Also, hope you guys enjoyed the Super Bowl. Kind of enjoyed that. That was pretty good. Enjoyed the Super Bowl commercials. I thought actually a lot of the trailers were okay. I thought the movie trailers were great. 10 Cloverfield Lane, Deadpool, and Avengers Civil... Oh, Captain America Civil War are all like my favorite. It was great. It was great. Anyway, also, sorry if I am being a little bit more bitter in these replays, so I'm pointing that out. Don't try to be. Not Empire Rommel. Not even close. But I sometimes get annoyed, and it's been pretty stressful. Nice mortar hit knocking out that enemy MG. Was that Soviet mortar? I assume it was Soviet mortar. Yep, Soviet mortar for the win. Anyway, yeah, things have been pretty stressful. Nothing you guys need to worry about, but just, like I said, I'm just going through a transition, trying to figure out what I'm doing next, and, yeah. Also, make sure you like and subscribe. That really does help overall. Sorry for me kind of emphasizing that, but, I don't try to say it too often, but it does help now and again. Alright, nice, whatever that, oh, nice mortar, I assume. We have a rifleman going through mid. Riflemen actually doing not half bad, especially in every cover. The problem is there's two Volk squads hanged from two different angles. So it's simply put a flank, and the flank is doing quite a lot of damage. Think of it XCOM. XCOM, you do more damage when you flank the enemy. Anyway. Doing actually not bad in XCOM 2. Highly recommend those streams as well. Oh my god. Unfortunately, who was it? Joe Devastated died along with a lot of my recruits. Permadeaths in that game, so when people die, they die. Now, kind of like Company of Heroes 2 with these, you know, troops. Nice mortar, I assume. British mortar? Yep, British mortar. We can see here again, Rifleman slowly but surely pushing back the Volk squads. Volk's not as powerful. As riflemen, but you know, not half bad either. They have their own perks and advantages. This MG is the, oh my god, Psychotron. why you would put it there is beyond me. First MG34, so it's not very powerful. Like as we can see here with fortifications, he's in mid. I actually don't mind that he went fortifications, because we look at his perspective, you can easily put bunkers in these locations. MG34 in this building is actually pretty good, or in this building. I actually like this centralized location. You can have a lot of space, negative cover for the enemy charge. It's great. Also, my god, Stern Pioneers for the win. But anyway, you can also, again, get pack 43, hide it behind the buildings, and bada bing, bada boom, you knock out a lot of armor. Also, mines, especially. Oh my god, play so many mines. Anyway, we continue on. Not sure why you have an MG in there. I'd highly recommend just in there somewhere. Let's see. Continuing on, flak emplacement's okay, not great. Not as good as I want to. Good against aircraft, though. Good against aircraft. Rifleman easily going to push back these Stern Pioneers. You're literally going to charge them to their... Alright. Whatever. That's cool. Let's see. Looks like there's a lot of troops over here. Double team, as it were, with a sniper. Probably push back T-Kev's infantry. Although his mortar's been doing pretty well. It's just hurting a lot of enemies. Also, we can see here he's putting a forward assembly to add a bonus to the mortar. Again, for those who don't know, and if oh my god, I watched an Empire Rama video, and he doesn't play this game anymore, and he's like, hey guys, why would you put a forward assembly, right? So, like, it doesn't make sense, you have a glider and a forward assembly. Dude, you put the forward assembly when you have excess of manpower and you want to boost your emplacements. That is something, it's like, it's common sense, and the fact that it's like, this person's who commentating doesn't know that, it's like, god dang it. Don't get me wrong, I'm not an expert, but he's going there just like, ugh, I don't know. I'm just like, god dang it. Whatever. Anyway, as long as the territory is connected, they're going to heal, which you can see exactly what he's doing. That's why he didn't retreat, that way he could just heal his guys. Now, the enemy does have to, well, T-Kev, or aka No Sacrifice, does worry about the Volk squads, because they can get Panzer Trucks. Also, we have a Verkennwerfer, which can easily uproot emplacements. We have a large assault over here. A lot of guys with G43 rifles. Good for sniping and interrogation. You can, if you interrogate a dead body, you can reveal all the enemy positions on the map. It's very vital and very, very cool, in my opinion. Also, really like how, again, we can see here, this guy, Med, took this location, cutting off the fuel and resources over here. Very, very vital. That being said, again, this flank is not going without its repercussions. We can see here maybe a rifleman squad may die. If he doesn't get retreat, nice grenade. Gonna own that pretty much Grenadier squad. Ooh, nice MG42. I would grab that if I was that guy. Kind of blobbing, honestly, but you know, whatever. Happens now and again. We have a large counterattack moving through. Looks like there were some mines placed, so very nice job. Vickers, however, is suppressing those troops. However, well, he has enough for, what, 3 rifle grenades? We could probably kill that building if need be. Also, scout car coming in. Could do a lot of damage. But, you know, probably want to hit this, but that's just me. Wow, a lot of troops coming in. He wants to retreat and get the heck out of there. And yes, I dissed Empire Rommel, by the way, a little while ago. But not in a negative way. I just find it funny because I learned that he doesn't play this game anymore. It's like, yeah, you kind of need to know what's going on if you want to play. I'm just saying. If you commentate, you probably should be intertwined within some capacity. Anyway, continuing on. Yeah. Oh, again, nice counter. Stern Pioneer's trying to knock him down, but there's so many riflemen. Alright, retreat this. Throw a grenade. Insta-wipe. All very close. He did kill the rifleman because he sucked. Metaman, you actually lost a lot of troops there. Never mind, you kind of blobbed and you kind of failing. And this guy's kind of blobbing too. As you can see, this huge infantry section. But the riflemen are just in heavy cover and they're just mowing them down. Also, again, we can see here, path airborne. You get the pathfinders with these awesome, awesome guns. They have weak armor, but man oh man, can they snipe. The problem is, the Germans have the same weapon except better armor and more. So that's why they're tearing the pathfinders apart. Kind of sucks in that regard, but hey, whatever. Still a good upgrade to do for sniping infantry with low health. I think the sniper uses G43 rifle as well. They're just not as trained, so it gets put in retrospect. Oh my god, retreat. Anyway, T-Kev is back at base, aka No Sacrifice. Looks like he's been trying to get his men back. He has 800 manpower along with Medwood 7. Probably just ranking up, trying to get some things special. Let's see. You have a centaur. Okay, you saved up for a centaur. That's why you're saving up. You wanted to get that. On this left side here, with the Soviet player, Eldum. Let's see. He went to Soviet combined arms, which, okay, this is pretty good. Gives him the howitzer, which is pretty good for hitting the enemy base, causing havoc. IL-2 bombing strike is good for hitting fortified positions, and the guard's troops are great for sniping infantry, and better at just annoying vehicles. Looks like the Germans have pretty much fortified this center, MG over here, pretty standard stuff. They have this artillery officer, which, yeah, the coordinate barrage will tell all artillery, which aka the mortars here, to hit a specific target, which is good. The problem is, though, I don't know if they, you know, how much range do you have to be. Also, the smoke's pretty good, and the concentrate fire's okay. So it's overall not a bad unit. I think if you kill the officer, everything retreats. I think. I know the Sturm officer does that. I'm not sure about the artillery field officer. Because of the fact that I almost never see this unit on the field. Compared to the Ford Assembly, which, yeah, of course, if you're saying, ooh, how do you know that? Well, this is used every game. I almost never see the artillery field officer, because I really don't like it, because they really don't like using its special abilities. But that's just me. We shall see, because of course the Allies are pushing. And look, the Soviet player, which is fortified over here, is pushing in mid and helping his ally out. That's a really good player. That's a really good player. We have special operations, good for recon and supporting with upgraded Opel Soldaten and the Command Panther. It's all sorts of really interesting abilities. And Vlint went assault support. You get the Tiger and also the awesome fragmentation bomb for hitting fortified targets, and the strafing support, which holds stuff down. Guard's rifle. You can see here it's been buttoned, so they can try to rush up and kill it. If you can do an AT grenade, that would probably kill it, maybe. Or just throw a grenade in there. That's fine. Whatever. This is probably the bigger target, but that's okay. You can see here, Accuser was pushing through, and he went Lightning War. You get the awesome Stukas, G43s, and a Tiger, so two Tigers. We look over here, they went Infantry Company. You get the Mortar Priests, which are great. You get the Mortar Half Track, which is pretty good. And Rifleman can lay down field defenses, and get LMGs. Also, time on target is not underestimated. Get owned. Jesus Christ. Yeah, look at them rifling, just sniping those Volk squads. And man, if you snipe those Volk squads again, you just keep killing them. I'll give it this. What? Who is this guy? Jew? Oh my god. I'm sorry. But anyway, this guy's been doing really well, just sniping the enemy infantry, just really well. Also, Centaur, just mowing him down. Because again, they have a lot of AT, but this thing is very mobile and very good, just mowing, and just, again, causing lots of damage in a short amount of time in the infantry. So again, he tried to circle around there, knock out the mortars. We have infantry coming around the flank, but the mortar or a mine or something hit that. We have white phosphorus hitting this area from the half tracks, which again is used to counter mortars, because again, they're mechanized. They can take hits. These things can't. Nice flank with the centaur as well. Coming in on weakened infantry. So the if you're wondering why that's good, centaur will literally mow down anything that's weak. So that's actually a really good combo. What, use white phosphorus and then use this insta-kill weapon to pretty much annihilate all of these mortars in pretty much one strafe. Like so. This is evil. This is absolutely evil. And it's like, well, there's three mortars down the drain. Oh, look, there's the, another building. Oh, no, sorry, the vehicle, building that the OKW has that retreated. Still, just moving around, causing so much damage. The Volk squads are just, like, being peppered. Ugh. Good attacks. I really like these guys' assaults. Even though they're having the fuel, they're putting a lot of pressure over there, making sure they can't really take anywhere else. We have a lot of men hitting mid right now, but yeah, it's very interesting because of this. And again, you could call that American Blob. I will call that an American Blob because it is an American Blob. I mean, honestly. But he has a lot of vetted troops, so I can't complain. But he is mortar spamming. This med guy is mortar spamming. Absolutely, he's mortar spamming. But it looks like he's about to... Ooh. Are you getting up? No, you're not getting an upgrade. Let's see. Yeah, right now you're cut. Oh, nice job killing one. No sacrifice, no... Oh, we have a strafing support coming in. Again, very nice for suppressing all the infantry. So, allowing the fewer in number and technically weaker OKW squad to win just because of the air support. That being said, the Centaur could probably shoot it down. Where's Centaur? Where are you? Centaur, where are you? There you are. Yeah, it's actually in range, kind of, so it could shoot down the plane. So that's why he's probably moving to mid to shoot down the plane. There it goes. Almost hitting the retreating. If it would have moved a little bit more and hit that infantry right there, I would have... That plane is MLG. That plane is the best plane ever. It is the best kamikaze plane ever of all time. Anyway, moving on. No sacrifice. Let's see. You went Vanguard Operations. Crocodile's really good for burning infantry and fighting medium to light armor. Strafing support's good for just peppering an area. For logistics... Logistics glider is also pretty nice at just being a forward operation post, although I'd recommend a forward assembly more. I like the glider just because of its ability for recon, so you can lay it down and gives recon over the area. That's just me. Looks like we have some Soviet mines over here. Very, very nice. Again, I lay mines everywhere as the Soviets, because we can see here again, the British should get a lot of munitions, but also the Soviets do as well. Wow, this guy has a nice little army. Very nice, very nice, very nice. Let's see. Probably should focus on munitions. And also, probably should focus... Like, this guy's a decent army, but he has to take out this American guy, because right now there's two massive armies going toe-to-toe, which is actually quite kind of funny. I love how these groups have, like, these giant, massive armies just rolling around the battlefield, and it's, like, waiting to engage. It's like, oh, we engaged the center of town, now the German army's pushing up. Anyway, we have Pathfinders here. They don't have the special. I think the recon support has the special where they can call in very explosive artillery rounds. But, yeah. The problem is, in this case, they have more infantry better equipped. Jesus Christ, there goes the church, ladies and gentlemen. That plane just being shot down again. Oh, my God. Anyway, German forces pushing through, getting annihilated, pulling back. They're just being hit. 50 cal machine gun. Not that bad. Ooh, hitting some mines. Nice minefield. I really like that. Again, waiting. Oh my god, is he still moving forward? That's what you get for not instantly retreating. But again, he knew that the American player had a large infantry force, so he placed mines. Very, very smart. Gonna pretty much own this poor engineer squad just walking in like, hey, what's up? Boom. Let's see, we have decent armies. Looks like the Soviet player doesn't have a front line force anymore. Well, now he does, but yeah, it's kind of weak. Jew has a nice front line army, very nice, also ranked up. This guy's a good, I would say, support force, not really a front line, per se. And no sacrifices, a decent force, kind of scattered about. This area, they are taking some difficulties, and as we can see, there was Opel Sedan with... SDG 44 is making them very, very deadly to any infantry unit, even MGs. One of these could pretty much kill an MG if need be, if like flanking and mow it down. Unfortunately for him, there's a Centaur coming in, and Opel Sedan do have heavier armor, which allows them to take more hits, but it's still infantry, so they can still take, they're still going to be annihilated overall. So I don't know why he's staying in the fight, honestly. I guess he tried to kill the AT grenade, but that's a waste because he's just going to fall back or reman it. So, if double Stugs, oh, that's what he wanted to do. He wanted to kill the AT gun to move in the Stugs. Yeah, here's a tip, dude. When there's two giant armies, don't move up. Don't move up. That's just me. Because you're going to get annihilated. And there are two Stugs down in a blink of an eye. We have a German Air Force moving in, suppressing a lot of men. Probably will fall him back. Or let the plane kill it. I think that's a third plane that vehicle is killed. I think? Well, it's a third plane that's gone down, for sure. So it's pretty epic. It looks like here the Germans have pretty much captured City Square. And actually, it looks like dealt a critical blow to this guy. Knocked out the Sherman and a bunch of other stuff. I'm going to guess that was the Volk squads and the Panzer IV. Now, the Panzer IV hasn't gotten anything, so I'm assuming... Where are you? I'm assuming it was just a combo hit. But again, this yellow guy is fighting two people right now. This Soviet player is still over here. He's kind of just leaving his units haphazard. I would actually push. See, the enemy is kind of focusing a lot of efforts on breaking Tikhev, aka No Sacrifice, and his ally. Well, the Soviet player is over here kind of supporting. And Med. I mean, that's fine too. But if you can come around, push this way, knock out the fuel point, and either start hitting the guy's base or flank around and hurting here, That would be very, very helpful. I've had replays before where the enemy doesn't help a struggling ally and they attack the enemy base. That being said, it was like one of the worst base assaults I've ever seen. If you cripple, you don't even have to do all that much. If you just move in and let's say, here's a good example, kill the infantry company, or you kill the support armor corps, that render, even if it's a raid, you neutralize that guy's ability to make armored vehicles, and that would seriously help. Or you draw his forces away. Right now, there is no draw. There is no pull and push from the Soviet player over here, so they're slowly moving up and taking territory in the meantime. Anyway, Panzer IV is moving up. Unfortunately, it's taking some damage from these guys. You can see the AT grenades, most likely. There's a lot of men coming up, but unfortunately, even with the MG, which I would highly recommend doing armor-piercing rounds, which this guy is failing to do. Yeah, it still suppresses them and pushes them back. Again, I would recommend that. We have a Jackson moving up. Most likely a Jackson would beat the Panzer IV. Unless the Panzer IV is really crafty and has support. Looks like we have P-47s coming in, which I don't know why you would do that. There's really no... That building saved the... What the fuck is with... Oh my god. Man, I am just getting lucky with all the plane crashes today. My god. It's literally just like... The Air Force in general is just not happy. Oh my god. Nice Katusha hit. Knows where the enemy is, trying to neutralize them. Unfortunately, we do have some Panthers on the field. But that being said, we have a nice wide range. A lot of AT guns right now. Very nice. And a Centaur. Again, oh, 30 kills. Dude, your Centaur is wrecking house, TK. TKF, sorry. TK's tank killer. Although, tank Kavu, aka No Sacrifice, could be it. Anyway. 1,800 manpower, dude. 1,800 manpower. Okay, I'm going to criticize. A little criticism. Get some infantry section. Dude, you could get a lot of infantry section. You get MGs. You could get a good infantry force up. You get sniper. Dude, get three snipers. Unless you're getting three snipers. If you get three snipers right now, I will call my... I will say you're the best player ever. Because I've done that before. I actually started doing the British sniper spam. It works so well. I can't believe it. No, it works against lower level players, high level players. Like these guys should be doing is just get a Stuka and just murder these guys, which they really honestly should be doing. It looks like this plane's kind of chasing that plane. That's cool. Well, there goes another plane. Oh, one Katusha hit probably. Dude, if these units are taken out, that is GG. Looks like we have a priest firing, not really doing all that much damage per se, but if it's pounding this area, that could accidentally kill a lot of troops, which could be very bad. Lots of mortars still coming in. These guys are still firing with their mortars, so I'll give them credit. Coming through, guards, troops are going to probably die. Lots of, again, the Opel Sedan with the STG-44s and, again, the Volks squads. Not a half-bad combo. Also, we can see here they're pretty much ranked up. If he loses them right now... God damn. Oh my god. You want to get that rank. Oh my god. 3-star Centaur is nothing to be, like, sneeze at. It is a pretty powerful unit. We see here that Jackson's going toe-to-toe with the Panther. The problem is, Jackson's good, Panther's better. long range, Jackson wins. Close range, Panther wins. Also, we can see a bunch of random stuff around here. I'd pick that up if I could. Right now, the Allies control all three major points, which is their saving grace. But yeah, they need to really change it up because... Actually, you take it back. No, this purple guy is just being annihilated. Oh my god. Dude, I'm getting these planes cannot stay in the air. Oh my god. That poor medic squad. No, mechanized repair squad. They didn't deserve it. Oh my god, that was painful. But anyway, this guy is losing a lot. A Stuka would be great, in my opinion, to knock out this stuff. Although, it looks like the SCG-44 did the trick. I thought he decrewed it for a second. We have some type of thing coming in. I assume that... Yep, time on target. Not sure why he threw it there, but whatever. Oh, strafing support coming in, pushing back the Panthers. Nice job. You can see their planes flying around. Again, one will hit infantry, the other will hit actual armor. So not bad. Looks like, again, they've made... But here's the thing. The Germans have pushed through this line pretty well. So... This Panther is, like, really, like, on the edge of, like, if it, one strafe, it's dead. Nice, actually, terrible Katusha. You really want to wait for the blob before you fire. Looks like this Panther will escape. I love the artillery in the air, just firing the planes flying around. That's pretty cool in my book. Those planes flying around are pretty epic. Sorry, I'm a person, like, I'm scared of heights, but I ever since I was a kid, I was fascinated with aircraft. A little tidbit about me. Oh my god. Just Stuka firing. We have another plane coming in. I'm guessing that's a Soviet one. Yeah, recon plane. Oh, it looks like the German plane's chasing the other one. That's pretty cool. Yeah, with the German plane coming in. Oh! Shoot. Never mind. German plane just went down. Oh my god. That was a strafing support. But yeah, it looks like they pushed in pretty well. But the Allies pretty much made one last final stand and actually held pretty well. Now you have a Churchill. Dude, you really need to... You have 1,800 manpower. Use it. The American player with the giant army has more... It's like, he has no excuse. He has also all of his troops pretty much alive. Looks like he just fell back to heal. Yeah, right now, I think a Panzerwerfer would be great. What is this, Ventil? Yeah, he has a good army. This guy's been constantly under fire. This guy's been really, really well keeping his men alive. Looks like time on target. Could knock out the build. Nope, missed the building. Alright. Knocked out the one mortar squad. Congratulations. 3-star Centaur, not half bad. 43 kills, pulling it back. Churchill moving up. We have a blob moving in mid. Looks like the American player is trying to come in. Looks like they kind of leveled this area. Oh my god. Remember there used to be buildings and a town square right here? Yeah, they're no longer. We have a Tiger coming in. We have a Jackson coming out with a flank. So that could be interesting. I do like the flank. Oh, Tiger. And oh. G43s. Oh, that's what I mean by Katusha strike. Hit the blob. What the heck? How is that? Well, that was a good hit. This Tiger's probably gonna die. It's probably gonna be hit by, like, a Jackson shot to the butt. Oh, never mind. This thing lived. I truly thought he would have died. But, again, they're pushing up. Oh my god, that Tiger on fire looks awful. The Tiger's on fire. And it's just like, nope. Killed the priest. Oh, maybe he's actually just saving up for a big armor thing, but the crocodile's trying to burn it. Kill another priest. Again, the Churchill still has a gun that can hurt this tank, so I don't know why the Tiger's charging. But the Tiger on fire is pretty epic in my book. Anyway, it's not going to do any damage, but hey, the Churchill can take at least a few shots from the Tiger. The Panther, probably not as much. Oh, double Jackson, very nice. If this guy was smart, he would have actually kept going. Because right now, he could have probably taken out that Katusha. Actually, I take it back. That was probably good, because there's a lot of AT forces moving up. Although, as you can see here, Katusha, if he could rush his men and take out the Katusha, that would probably be a huge, huge win for the Germans. Or he can move here and take out the Jackson. That would be probably a big win. Let's see if he does it. It's probably going to miss. Nope, he's going to retreat. Probably a smart move. Don't want to fight the blob. Don't want to fight the blob. Anyway, so the Germans finally take the hill after a long, long confrontation. I have a feeling, though, that that the allies are not done yet. So anyway, we can see here he's doing vehicle repair. Again, this will put smoke down, which is really annoying to the enemies. Goddamn, why is my game... There we go. That's smoke. Whatever. Anyway, we can see here the smoke covers the vehicle as they repair. Also, we have vehicle recruits. So he's pretty much being I guess he's just being focused on vehicles, which is okay. He kind of should have been using more of that manpower, honestly. In my opinion. Lots of mortars still coming down, causing a lot of damage to the infantry. Blobs still here. Katusha firing, hitting mid, I assume? Is that an SCG 44? No, it's PTRS. Lost the 50 cal, I assume. Oh, armor-piercing rounds. Why you use them? I'm being serious now. Those things are awesome. Some type of plane moving in. Some type of support. I'm guessing... What is this? Strafing support. All right. Ooh, that's strafing support. And artillery. Time on target. Neutralized. All but one. Poor, poor mortar. Which should retreat by now, if I was that mortar. I would instantly retreat. I like how they're literally chasing this goddamn mortar. Whatever. So it looks like the... I was going to say that the British took the hill, and then the British aircraft was just shot down out of sight. So, yeah, maybe not. Maybe not. The Germans could still come in with a lot of forces. Where are you? Oh my god, something's going on over there, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see what's going on over here. We have a large army moving up, Katusha's firing, planes firing overhead, Panthers on standby. We have a recon plane, we have a P-47 flying in. We're going to do some shots. Ooh, some nice shots. Actually, I take it back. After seeing all these planes crash, I'm probably not going to think about the Air Force anymore. Nice Stuka causing lots of damage to the infantry on the American side. Really nice plate. Also, another P-47 strafe coming in. Remember, it targets vehicles, but as long as they move, they can pretty much dodge the plane. Also, anti-air fire from this is probably the main reason why it's dead. Wow, another plane crash. So many planes going down in this game. So many planes. But yeah, the Oblast-Sudan mechanized headquarters, like, I guess the Panzer headquarters, well, has the gun on it, is really, really good at shooting down enemy planes, along with... Really? Hold on. I'm assuming he just lost most of his men through something. Also, the King Tiger kind of blocking his Tiger from escape is probably not helping. Huh, but that's weird that Vinyl left. Overall, though, I would say that this, even without... Oh, that was a nice bombing run. Oh my god. 17-pounder, perfect location, right on top of the hill, waiting for them to push up. And with that, that was some nice sniping shots. Although, to be fair, we can see here recon planes going out. Looks like the fortifications guy uses special to pretty much call down artillery. And it will keep calling down artillery as long as there's enemies within this zone. And since there is, well... Yeah. Just caused quite a bit of damage. It won't hit fortifications, but it'll hit everything else. So, yeah, looks like the Allies have won this battle, even with all the artillery trying to break them. Plane flying overhead. It'll probably die soon. I don't know what's worse, the artillery hitting the buildings or the planes hitting the buildings. I swear to God, I think there have been more planes killing buildings than anything else. Alright, let's look at overall men. This guy lost his Tiger. He has double Stuka, but again, without the Tiger... Okay, he's a decent amount of men, but the Allies... decent amount, still kind of weak. Kind of focused on vehicles. Small decent at front line, but small. Soviet player pretty much been crushed. Yeah, so even with that, it's a pretty good game, I'll say this. Pretty, still really good. Feel bad that Vinyl left, and I kind of... Yeah. Looks like he lost the crocodile in that engagement, but Churchill and the Centaur are still doing pretty good. Look at that, 48 kills, 7 vehicles, probably all them planes. Not bad. Finally, this guy pushes over here. Dude, this Soviet player's been slowly, like, whittling his forces. It's interesting that this guy's like, maybe I should go check on this. Are you kidding me? Why are you moving this way? Take the fuel. And no, you're not AI, so I know you're smart enough to realize. Also, you have 1,300 manpower. You can easily get more men. And you, before you say, Greyshot, what could he get? Very simple. Get third upgrade. Oh, look, he has it. You get a Panzerwerfer. That's what you need for this. That's what he's not getting. I hate when people don't get Panzerwerfers because they think they're terrible. Honestly, they're really, really good. People just have to focus on hitting blobs. They're not a Katusha. They're not a Stuka. They're the Panzerwerfer. They have their own perks and benefits and also weaknesses. It's still a good artillery piece, and it'll still own enemy armor if you hit them directly. Or planes gain some nice shots. German armor pushed back. I like how these 50 cal, like the 50 cal, 42. Ooh, that was a big hit. Oh my god. Oh, it shot down too. Oh no. Plane down over here. Almost hitting the Centaur. And yeah, another plane over here. Oh my god, so many planes going down this game. It's great. But yeah, I don't understand why this guy doesn't attack the Soviet player. This Soviet player was great, and he's slowly been getting terrible. I swear to god. Nice. Okay, this is... Okay, for those who don't know, the Stuka Close Air Support is one of my favorite abilities, because it pretty much annihilates enemy armor. It truly, truly does. As long as the enemy doesn't have anti-aircraft guns, it'll just keep flying around and annihilate pretty much any armor within this area. Which, at Jackson's, being medium armor, they will pretty much be taken out. The problem they have is... Nice hit. The problem right now is this Centaur that's over here. They're shooting down every plane at the German send, which... essentially is the worst part about any type of... I think this is like the perfect time to like highlight the fact that anytime you have a plane based support ability, oh my god, Yellow's infantry has just been annihilated. Probably a Stuka hit, if I'm assuming. 11 kills, 13. Yeah, I'm gonna assume Stuka. But yeah, so anyway, if you're wondering, like, oh, gray shots, like, well, the plane abilities are so good. Yeah, they're good, but you can easily counter them. The only thing you can't really counter is artillery, and I wish they could have... it's hard to figure out a system in which artillery would be less. My only concern... maybe they could do something where if you have a recon and you have artillery a sector, it does more damage than already on a place that isn't. It would be, like, more scattered. Anyway, Katusha and less damage. Katusha trying to hit, but it's doing a little bit. Again, this is 285. Jesus Christ, get your AT weapons in there and do a Panzerfaust. You have enough munitions for it. Dude, a Panzerfaust would have killed that thing. That's why I think, like, this guy is like a hint of genius and a hint of stupidity all in one. We have a flank coming in, but again, the 17 pounder. You don't flank a 17 pounder, it just turns and owns you. Especially on top of the hill. You know how you kill a 17-pounder? Also, we can see here, it's using the special to fire through buildings, being a Pack 43. That being said, Pack 43 does it for free. This thing does it 90 munitions. It's a rip-off. The British are ripping you off. It's like when you get a game console and they announce it. It's like $4.99 American US dollars, $4.99 British pounds, $4.99 Australia. Oh my god, why you have your Stuka so close? It's beyond me. I guess you tried to move it up, but dude, as soon as you see it, just move it back. I'll give you this, no sacrifice. You have a good, your armor's been sound. Like, except for the one Churchill dying, your armor's tactics and, like, units have been doing really, really well. And I will, like, gladly praise you for that. However, as I say this, your you still have so much manpower that you should be getting infantry. You really need infantry. But yeah, he put this. That's why it's also better, because he has his fort assembly boosting the quote-unquote 17-pounder, which I keep wanting to say quarter-pounder because I'm hungry, until I saw that thing where someone like hit a Big Mac for 6 years and the Big Mac didn't change, and I'm like, nope, not eating at McDonald's anytime soon. Probably will forget about the image and eat there shortly, but not anytime soon. Glider coming in. Most likely, I'm assuming, taking the point. If Germans pushing over here. Dude, this orange guy is seriously, seriously annoying me right now. He could own this entire area, force and kill yellow, but he keeps... This is what I always say, and I hate when people say, Greyshot, you're wrong, Greyshot, it's like you're stupid, Greyshot, that never works. Attack the enemy where they're weak, not where they're strong, alright? They keep using all these specials, all these, all these quote-unquote abilities over here, and it's so tiring, it truly is, because A, there's no vehicles over here, so what are these vehicle things gonna do? The only vehicle that right now is a centaur. God damn. And a centaur is just gonna shoot him down. Like so. Where are you? There you are. It's really annoying. Honestly, this orange guy could have won the game for the Axis, but they didn't. And I say the same thing as the Soviet player. Soviet player could have won it by doing an awesome flank. It's funny how both players who could have won the game are just like, oh my god, so stupid. Anyway, it's like they're meant for each other. They can go back and forth. This guy could easily push, take all the fuel resources, cut the Americans' supply chain in half, and just knock them out. But no, apparently that's the stupid thing to do. Also, when you attack, also again, you would knock out the Katusha, you would knock out sword stuff, and before you say Greyshot, he doesn't have the See, he has Panzer Grenadiers, of course he has it. Or he may have lost them, to be fair, I'll give you that, but you're attacking the enemy where they're strong. This guy is double Jacksons in a front line. Well, he did until the Stuka kind of ruined it, but you get the point. He had a good front line. You're going through this tiny little crevice. Why? You were doing so well in wide open territory over here, just annihilating the Soviet player. You could have taken the star. You could have took the fuel. You could have even probably taken this point and even the munitions point. And dude, if you would have kept going and doing your recon, which, by the way, you have an ally that has recon that hasn't left yet before you say anything. You could have found this base, knock it out, that's two players out of the game, and boom, bada bing, you win. I feel like this is a great example because the Germans would have probably won this game if it wasn't for this idiot thinking he has to attack the enemy where they're strong, and he's sending a quote-unquote infantry force against armor, like the Churchill and that, which, by the way, the Churchill, we can see here, cruise. Well, enemy infantry using small arms. They will literally use guns inside the Churchill to own infantry. So what is a bunch of infantry going to do against a Churchill and stuff like that? Nothing. Nothing. And you're sending in, once again, armor, which, don't get me wrong, I think armor is a good choice to take that out. And I do feel like, okay, you Panzerfaust did it, great. But right now, you're gonna, if I'm looking at the points right, you guys are gonna about to lose by stars. Because you failed to take this point. And I love Accuser, how you say good game, because honestly, also, you have so much manpower, it's ridiculous. So much manpower. You literally sacrificed it. Your allies, like, this is the point where I'm looking right now, and no offense, TK, you did awesome. Your armor's still alive, great. That's fantastic. This guy's been pretty good with Artie. He's kind of pre-spamming, but whatever. Doesn't really have much of a front line. Yellow, I will give you this. Great infantry. Even though he's been kind of suffering some losses, he's been doing pretty well. Terrible position for a Pack 43. Put it behind here, idiot. Because, I'm sorry to call him an idiot, but honestly, put it behind your fire. Yeah, it was a good game, honestly. Oh, nice shot. Kill the Jacks on the retreat. But both what I love is the fact that Oh, now the Sylvia player comes in from behind. Okay, whatever. But as I was... Oh my... Yeah, turn the pack 43, dude. Random Stug. Sure, why not? That makes total sense. Instead, you could have gone the Tiger, but who am I to say? I'm sure the Stug is so much greater. But at any point, I just find it so interesting because it was an even fight. Even with the AI, it was still a really good game, and I really enjoyed it. But like I said, I feel like the Sylvia player, aka, who is this, Eldum? What rank is he? Okay, he's a lower rank player, and WT Accuser, who is a higher rank player, both the high rank player and the low rank player hit the same thing where they both failed. Now, oh my god, so many people use 7 the rockets coming in. So many planes in the air. Some last ditch artillery to kill this infantry, but not much. Did a plane really a plane crashed over there again? And I missed it. Oh well. Whatever. In any capacity. Oh, that's a cool shot of the plane coming in. Love the. This would be incredibly stupid. I love games with planes, and then I hate them at the same time. Oh my god. Because, for example, my favorite game, Bad Company 2, and they're like, Battlefield 3, routing planes. I'm like, yay! And then it's like, we're going to add automatic lock-on stingers. Boo! No skill. Whatever. Anyway, love planes still. Absolutely love it. In any case, that was a really good game. I did like everyone's preference. I did like everyone's playstyle. Jew did really good with infantry. No Sacrifice did really, really well with armor. I mean, that Centaur dude, 61 kills. Not half bad. Again, 64,000 damage, just probably for shooting down all the planes and owning infantry. But Med got more infantry kills, probably because of all the mortar half-tracks and the priests, is my reasoning. We go here. WT Gorin was their best damage dealer and killer, who was, yeah, this guy. And actually, his King Tigers and Panthers did really well. And as you can see, finally did, and I'll give him this, finally pushed the Allies off that hill. Like I said, I feel like No Sacrifice should have gotten more infantry. I feel like that was one of their, you know, negatives. This guy relied too much on artillery. I would say 2 priests was enough and then get armor and infantry, but he wasted 3. Probably was saving for 4 if I'm looking at this right. So yeah, that was their waste. This Soviet player was okay. I do find it that he did really well on certain aspects and then terrible at others. I like that he was helping his ally, but he didn't also... like, try to push his territory the maximum that he possibly could. And I feel like that would, instead of helping your enemy on the front line, flanking is better. Like XCOM. Adding another XCOM soldier to the front of an alien's blaster is not going to help you. You need to, if you circle around an alien with one unit, that will cause the rest of them to turn and be like, oh no, and then either retreat or get owned. And that's what they should have done, but they didn't do that. The same thing with Accuser. Accuser, I felt, did a really good job with his infantry, keeping them alive and going toe-to-toe with Jew. And his Tiger was also really good. The problem was, and this is the big one, he kept wasting these Stuka close air supports. They never killed the quote-unquote Centaur, which was the big thing and why their air support kept failing. And one of the biggest things I feel like is he didn't take the opportunity to own this guy's base. He could have easily done that. He could have easily moved in and crippled pretty much the entire Allied supply line and done the opposite of what the Sylvia player did. Instead of taking it on the Axis side, he could have moved up, easily did a critical blow on Jew, and easily probably won the game in that respect. Because again, you knock out this American position, it's GG. Which is also why I like close air support the doctrine, because again, you just do a recon pass, nice little Stuka strike, or suppress... No, I'm sorry. You be evil. You do a suppressing run at their base so they can't move or retreat, and then you do a Stuka bomb. That is evil. But anyway, that's just me. That is just me on overall gameplay. The rest of them, Gorn did okay. Like I said, he was doing good. Psychotron could have done better. I feel like Pack 43 was in a bad position, although he got some kills with it, good for you. And he was just an okay player overall. I did pretty good holding, I guess, the American blobs and such. But anyway, let's see, the worst player was WT Accuser. Again, not much damage, but decent on unit kills. And yeah, AI's okay. But in any case, that's game. I want to thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you like and subscribe and tune in next time where I probably look over another COH2 video. Hopefully, probably mine. Yeah, it'll probably be mine. Hopefully. Been playing a lot of XCOM 2, gonna be honest. But, you know, at least I play COH2. Anyway, enough with the burns. See you next time.